The wormhole theory is not a novel concept by any means. You must have heard about it quite some time ago, but when it first came out, it was only in written form. Recent findings by scientists have brought this theory one step closer to reality by revealing the existence of the very first wormhole. But before we get into the details of the discovery, subscribe to the Future Space. Let's do a little bit of background research to get a better idea of what it is all about. The concept of wormholes has been around since 1916, despite the fact that they weren't initially given that name. While examining a solution to the equations that Albert Einstein developed for general relativity that was provided by another researcher, Ludwig Flo came up with an alternative solution. He discussed a hypothetical time reversal version of a black hole known as a white hole. There is a possibility that there is a conduit in space-time that leads the mouse to both black holes and white holes. In 1935, researcher the name of Nathan Rosen made use of the theory of general relativity to develop a concept and imply the existence of bridges between space and time. The bridges connect two different places in space-time, which opens up the possibility of taking a more direct route, which in turn would cut down on both travel time and distance. Einstein is responsible for the wormholes. The shortened routes are referred to as Rosen bridges. According to Stefan Sue, a professor of theoretical physics at the University of Oregon, the entirety of the matter is speculative at this point, as reported by our sister site Life Science. A paper that was presented at the Conference on High Energy Physics and was published in the Journal of High Energy Physics states that wormholes have two mouths and a neck in between them. In all likelihood, the mouse will have the shape of a sphere, and its throat will either wind around in a way that requires a more circuitous route than the one you need to take, or it will be a section that is completely linear. Despite the fact that Einstein's theory of general relativity makes wormholes mathematically predictable, no one has yet to be observed traveling through one. It is possible to detect a wormhole with a negative mass by observing the way in which its gravitational field affects light in the neighborhood of some general relativity. The presence of wormholes that terminate in black holes can be enabled by certain solutions. A naturally occurring black hole, which is the result of the death of a star, is not capable of producing a wormhole because they are mutually exclusive. In different genres of science fiction, the reality of such travel is more problematic in general, despite the fact that we have not yet seen one of these trips. Wormhole sizes are depicted quite frequently, but we haven't actually come across any of them. At first, it is anticipated that primordial wormholes will exist at scales ranging from 10 to 33 centimeters. On the other hand, it's not impossible that some of them have ballooned to enormous proportions as the universe has expanded. A separate problem is one of stability. Sue is of the opinion that the hypothetical Einstein-Rosen wormholes would be unstable and of no use for transportation purposes. It is not known for certain whether or not such matter can be found in the cosmos. Sue believes that in order to maintain the integrity of a wormhole, an unusual kind of material would be required. On the other hand, more recent research has uncovered a wormhole that, despite having been open for an extended period of time and retaining its original state, contains exotic material. Because of its high negative pressure and negative energy density, this exotic matter, which should not be confused with dark matter or antimatter based solely on its behavior in specific vacuum, has a negative energy density. This week, a group of physicists from the Autonomous University of Barcelona in Spain revealed that they had successfully constructed a wormhole that tunnels a magnetic field via an additional special dimension. Isn't it incredible how a permanent magnet can do that? According to Stacy, a doctoral candidate in physics at the University of Buffalo and co-author of the study, this device starts acting like a wormhole. It is as if the magnetic field was transmitted through an extra special dimension. This device is able to move the magnetic field from one location in space to another while maintaining its invisibility to magnetic sensors along the way. The concept of a wormhole can be traced back to the thinking of Albert Einstein. Nathan Rosen, an associate of Albert Einstein's, made the discovery in 1935 that the general theory of relativity made it possible to construct bridges that link different locations in space-time to one another. There is currently no evidence to support the existence of space-time wormholes. On the other hand, in theory, these Einstein-Rosen bridges, or wormholes as they have come to be known, could enable things to quickly tunnel between vast distances. The wormhole that was just discovered is not a space-time wormhole, rather, it is a different kind of wormhole entirely. Instead, it is a futuristic version of an invisibility cloak, which was first proposed in 2007 in an issue of the journal Physical Review Letters. The problem was that in order for the group to construct this wormhole that obscured light, they would have needed to make use of materials that were extremely implausible and challenging to work with. According to Pratt, this type of wormhole would make electromagnetic waves invisible to anyone looking in from the outside. It has come to light, much to the relief of individuals who have an interest in wormholes, that the components required to construct a magnetic wormhole already exist and are much simpler to acquire. For instance, magnetic field lines can be bent or twisted when they are expelled from the interiors of superconductors, which are materials capable of transporting large amounts of current or charged particles. This results in the lines being expelled from the superconductors. This makes it possible for the magnetic field to behave in a manner that is distinct from that of the 3D world, which is the first step in concealing the magnetic field disturbances. In order to build their wormhole, the team devised a three-layered object that consisted of two concentric spheres and an internal spiral cylinder. The material for the inner cylinder was a ferromagnetic Mu metal, and it was used. Ferromagnetism is the most important type of magnetism, and ferromagnetic materials are where you'll find it. Mu metals, on the other hand, are permeable and are frequently used to protect electronic equipment. A very thin layer of YBCO, which is a high-temperature superconducting substance, was applied to the surface of the inner cylinder so that it could deflect the magnetic field that traveled through the interior. A total of 150 pieces of Mu metal were used in the construction of the finished shell. It had been precisely cut and positioned in order to counteract the bending of the magnetic field that the superconducting surface was responsible for. After that step was completed, the entire apparatus was put into a bath of liquid nitrogen because, in this particular scenario, high-temperature superconductors need to operate at low temperatures in order to be effective. Since magnetic field lines typically radiate from a central point and gradually lose their strength over time, the magnetic field should have been detectable from a variety of locations in the surrounding area. Because of the newly created magnetic wormhole, the magnetic field on the axis side of the cylinder suddenly appears to appear out from nowhere. This is because the magnetic field was channeled from one side of the cylinder to the other in such a way that it was undetectable while it was in transit. According to Pratt, if a device can funnel magnetic fields from one location to another, then it may be possible to take pictures of the body with the powerful magnet placed a great distance away. It is possible that adding the ordinary matter is all that is needed to destabilize a wormhole, whereas the addition of exotic matter can stabilize it to the point where human grazing can safely pass through it. Even if wormholes could be found, the technology available today is unable to keep them stable or cause them to grow. However, there is still the possibility that technology will one day be able to make use of them. What will happen if scientists suddenly discover a giant wormhole on our Earth itself? Do share your imagination with us in the comment section below, and do hit the subscribe button if you want to watch more videos like this. Please, if you like this video, click on the like button and share it with your family and friends. Thanks for watching.